I'm Shawn Urbanski, and I'm a research physical scientist at the Missoula Fire Sciences Lab, and I work with the Fire, Fuel, and Smoke program. One of the projects we're working on currently is it's a laboratory investigation of the pollutants that are released when wildfire fuels are consumed by fire. Looking at litter fuels, ponderosa pine needles, loblolly pine needles, Douglas fir needles, real simple fuel beds. But even though they're simple, they're really important in terms of there's a lot of this fuel out there that burns, and it's a major contributor to smoke. Right now we're putting together a model that predicts how much smoke is produced and how much of the different chemical pollutants that are in the smoke are produced based on the moisture of the fuels, the density, the packing of the needles, how densely packed are the needles, and also the depth of the fuel beds. Well, this has a couple positive benefits to the general public. One is involved with prescribed fires. If managers who conduct prescribed burns have better tools to predict how much smoke is produced, then they're less likely to produce more smoke than they had intended to, and you're less likely to have those unintended consequences of a local community being smoked out by a prescribed fire. And also during the wildfire season, when we're dealing with wildfires, it really can't be controlled, and there's not much land managers can do to stop the smoke production. They can, hopefully, with these improvements to the tools, be able to better predict how much smoke is being produced. And those improved predictions of smoke production feed into air quality models and allow the air quality modelers to give a better forecast as to what the smoke is going to be, both on local communities near the fire, but also communities hundreds of miles away, which can be easily impacted during the wildfire season when there's a lot of fires burning.